Hello, my Wealthy Wife family and friends. This is Ms. Sophia, author of Wealthy Wife, Meeting, Dating, and Management, as well as the founder of the Wealthy Academy, and of course, your godmother of affluent, rich, and wealthy romance. How are you doing, Wealthy Wife family and friends? Okay, once again, I want to say thank you for joining me. I do appreciate you being here with me and allowing me to share this moment with you, this information, this wisdom. From old school OG subscribers, humongous squeeze, squeeze, hug. I appreciate you and thank you for hanging out with me for all the years you have. I still can't believe we're going into the sixth year of this YouTube channel. Isn't that crazy? But I can believe it because when I look at how many videos I've done, gosh, I've done almost 600 videos because I've got over 200 right now as we speak that are open on the thing, which some of them are coming down. I'm about to go do another purge. And I still got over 350 that I took off the YouTube to do something else with. So almost 600 videos, wild, right? I have a lot to say and share. And if you're one of my newer subscribers, I want to say first, welcome to the world of Wealthy Wife. And once again, I appreciate you and thank you for being here with us. And hopefully you also become a long-term subscriber. Now, as I mentioned before, I'm going to mention these two things. I'm going to get into today's topic because this still comes back to core values and really understanding and knowing self. As I mentioned, I have the workbooks available to you to assist you. Some of you purchased them. Thank you very much. And I really look forward to hearing your feedback on how you feel using the workbooks because the goddaughters had insight, had a chance to get to them earlier than the general public, obviously. And they're using them and loving them. And again, they're very specific questions being asked that actually can help you really, really hone in and focus on what you're doing in your whys. So once again, it's core values is the first one. Who are you is the second one, which you know is my favorite question in the world. And then you are worthy. Those are the three main workbooks that require you to really sit down and do, you're working on different things. And then a fourth one is getting unstuck. And getting unstuck is just that. There's those like four steps that you can use whenever. This has you can use even outside of the workbooks. These are exercises you can use to help you when you get stuck because getting stuck is normal. When you're making changes, it is perfectly normal to have moments when you feel sad, when you feel concerned because there's like this emptiness and vacancy. Vacantness, yeah, there's vacancy because you're actually emptying out space. You feel alone, you feel lonely. Those are normal steps. Please understand your progress. You're going to have moments, and they're basically times for you to rest. And in our society, which has you pushing, pushing, go and go, remember that whole hustle and grind culture still exists. You got to be busy. You got to be doing. No. And especially as a woman, we have to take time to rest. Our periods were supposed to be the time to rest. But instead of relaxing and being at ease, women want to prove a point and wind up doing more and doing too much. That's why we have all these doggone diseases and illnesses, the fibroids, the cysts, endometriosis, and all the other things that are going haywire inside of our reproductive system. It's because women are pushing, we're doing too much. Comes a time when you must understand how to rest. So that book with those exercises really gets you, once again, it brings you back to the present because that's something that's also very important, is being present. Because once again, people are getting stuck in their past and their history, and they're thinking about their future, what they want, and no one is spending time in the present. Because guess where you are? You're here right now in this moment. And in this moment can be a many, many great things. So the exercise, once again, puts you in more control of what you're doing in your whys. So they really are great workbooks. Like I said before, the goddaughters love them. Excuse me. And also, I remember now the workbooks are $25. You can hit the description in the video, the video box. There's a link in there. There's also a course I did. It's a course I did. It's like $99 that goes deeper into the workbooks, gives you more examples and how to utilize them in a way that's going to really elevate you. Because my goal always is for you guys to become what I call a total package, a woman who is emotionally, excuse me, mentally, physically, and spiritually in a great place. Because you're willing to put in the effort. Because remember, you're worth it. No one's going to give you your self-worth. That is entirely up to you. I just discussed the coffee dates in the last one. That is lowering the bar. It really is. And women, once again, and they keep finding ways to make dating easier for men. Why? That's why they're wondering, thinking that they're the prize. Some of them do, which I think is hysterical. Most men, true men are not doing that, just so you know. And a true man does have, he wants to show off for you. Show off for you. They want to showcase you. They want to show you that they have the capacity to do for you. But if you lack the confidence, if you lack the knowing and the ability, once again, to really allow that to happen for you, once again, women are going to just continue to lower the bar. You already got women in 50-50 relationships, which this is basically a roommate situation. I don't care if you've got the next name, Mrs. next, you know, if Mrs. is your prefix, it's still a roommate situation, my opinion. Okay. But still, and that's most men too. Most men have a desire to take care of their wife and their family because their goal is to create a household, a place that their woman can be so she can raise the family. And, you know, because he wants to come home to a place that's happy. Oops, hang on a second. I didn't realize I forgot to turn off the heater. Sorry about that. Heater kicked on. Anyway, most men, like I said, they're really moving that space of being that masculine man that women are desiring, they claim they desire. He does desire to have a household where he is able to provide for his family. That hasn't gone anywhere. There are more men out there than you may realize that have a desire to do this. Do not allow other women to tell you otherwise. I'm just saying, they really do exist. But anyway, so you've got the core value programs, you got the four-part workbook series, you have the course that's on the Academy, workbook's 25, course is 99, and then also, I want to talk about our health. I know you're like going, where is this going? Well, but here's a kicker, because I was listening to something, this was years ago, I think it was a couple of years ago, that there was a study that was done. Because once again, this also can play into how women are actually selecting men. Because so many of the things that go on, when you understand how to be present with energy, when you understand how to really function in our world, it's energy for one, also smells. Our senses are a very important part of our process. And our senses, you know, taste, smell, sight, whatever, et cetera, are tied into our hormones. And there was a very interesting study done in reference to birth control, because that's you know, a hormone disruptor to keep your woman from ovulating. And they discovered that in a study that when a woman came off of birth control, a good portion of them, I mean a majority of them, were no longer attracted to their husband or their long-term boyfriend. And they couldn't figure out why. Like, what's going on? Because it was happening so often. And what they discovered was his smell. He did not have the fragrance, the form, the pheromones of like this really masculine, whatever, this primal man. And primal doesn't mean someone like who's just, you know, not un, who was unsmart and whatever, no, who's dumb and ignorant, whatever, no, there's 0, 0, 0. But like this man who really is that protector, provider, you know, someone that we feel safe with and we can build with or whatever, whoever they had picked as their husband and their boyfriend wound up not being a good match for them once they came off of the hormones. Off the birth control. And I thought about it. It's got me to thinking because then recently I came across a video. I was watching something. This, I think of a Dr. Jen, I forget her last name, starts with a G, but she's an OBGYN. And she would discover now they're actually studying how menopause affects a woman, a perimenopause and menopause affects a woman's body. Because for so long, the medical field just thought we were idiots. You know, she's just, what did she say they used to call it when a woman came in with symptoms that now they know are tied into perimenopause and menopause? They called it her a WW, a whiny woman. And if any of you have gone through into the medical field and dealt with doctors, male or female, man or woman, you know how dismissive they can be if you are someone who under that has no understanding of how to speak. In other words, how to speak up. Because they're not going to listen to you unless you speak up. And I know this for a fact because I've had to do it. I've been through a couple of situations myself, health-wise, which I've shared here on my Instagram, on Instagram and YouTube and in class, then reference to my nervous system went offline when I was dealing with those that nerve pain, which is still insane. But I literally had to speak up because these lunatics wanted to, they wanted to slice and dice me. They wanted to do spinal taps and, you know, they wanted all these invasive things they wanted to do in the name of science and figuring out what's wrong with me. And I flat out said no. Because they kept telling me I had to do the spinal tap. I go, I don't have to do anything. And they would come as a gang. They were four. I was like four of them would walk in. Thump, 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 thump. Four. There were three European descent and one melanated individual. I guess they thought if they brought him inside, it would make me more agreeable because I was so disagreeable, such a bad patient in their eyes. Because I kept telling them no. What we need to do, I go, no, you don't have to, I'm not doing it. I go, I'm going to run the risk of you injecting a potential infection into my body when I'm already struggling? No, thank you. I go, figure out how to figure out what you think it might be, and we'll go from there. But no spinal tap. And I mean, it literally, and they're slick. They do good cop, bad cop on you. And then they sent the melanated gentleman in to speak to me once again, trying to get me to read, trying to make me reason, be reasonable. Because once again, what could I possibly know? I'm just a woman. I don't know anything. Oh my gosh, I'm just not that smart, especially about my own body. Oh my gosh, big doctor man, help me out. No. Okay? But this is how they're going to do us, and how they do us when you don't have a voice. Hang on a second, my mic is acting up. So you have to remember that you must know how to speak up. So when I was listening to this doctor, like this OBGYN speak, and she was saying she thought the same thing about women. And the reverend said a whining syndrome until she became perimenopausal and she began to have symptoms that she couldn't figure out. She realized there has to be more to it. And because she began to have some of the symptoms that her clients, patients that were explaining they were struggling with. And so what they've discovered is there at the moment, and there's going to numbers going to rise, there are approximately 70 different symptoms affiliated with perimenopause and menopause. 70. And then the shame to me was this. You can be as young as 30 and be in perimenopause. Now that's shocking to me because last time I saw the number a few years ago, it was 35. And that was shocking to me because back in the day, perimenopause happened for a woman until they hit their 40s. Usually they're like 20, 42, 45, it would begin. Run about 8 to 10 years and be done. Perimenopause can run into our 60s now. I was like, don't play with me because I'm currently in perimenopause. I'm like into the 60s. I'm like, really? Not the norm, but it's actually a little more normal than I realized because I'm here to look about it. But 70 symptoms that can be affecting your mental state, your emotional state, your physical state, your spiritual state of being. Because remember, people are telling you that you're crazy. Oh, what are you talking about? Well, stop being so moody. You're too emotional. You're too this or that. And it literally is our hormone. And it is our hormones. Now think about this for a second, because this is something I'm going to be talking about because I'm going to be moving the conversation also into our health and well-being. Because remember, my goal is to be sure that you guys are becoming the total package, emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually. Because your health and well-being cause you to make great decisions or shitty decisions. Once again, I'm in a rush out here getting married, doing all these crazy things because hormones. You're having mood swings and feeling a certain kind of way about something? Hormones. And if there are ways that we can help to learn to be better and feel better, because how I got over my nerve pain thing, because that was a lot of stuff going on. And that's also when I realized I learned I had fibroids. And fibroids are a hormone disruption because of, the energy. And in my case, it was just exhaustion. And I was pushing myself too hard. I was going through a situation. I wasn't taking care of myself the way I should have in reference to a lot of things. I was working out, eating, whatever. I thought I was doing good. I really did. Because I was in great shape. I was in phenomenal shape. But the inside of me, because of the level of stress I was under, there was a ton of stress. It was just destroying my hormones, which in turn created the fibroids. So I had the nerve pain going on. I had the fibroids going on. But I am in perimenopause. There's no shame in saying it's a normal part of life. It is something that all women are going to go through at some point in life. And she was naming off symptoms, and there were some symptoms that I had no idea were symptoms of perimenopause. Like there's a shoulder pain you get. I've had it. It's painful. It's really, really painful. And they call it frozen shoulder. I've dealt with it. And she was saying that when her patients they deal with it, it takes up to 2 years of physical therapy for them to fix it. Now, what my saving grace was, I have spent so many years working out and training, weight training and doing things, 'cause I was very much into fitness, that I would just do exercises I knew would help the shoulder and, and stretching. So I just worked out the details myself. But imagine someone who didn't have or doesn't have my kind of training and background. And there are a couple other symptoms I discovered that pains I'll have periodically that are tied into the perimenopause with the estrogen and the progesterone, going down, 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 down. So now, with me knowing this, I'm paying more attention to the foods I eat, and I'm going to be going online to find, some natural products I can use, because I used to use this bioidentical progesterone I was using, and I'm going to probably go back to that and probably add a little estrogen to it as well. Now, this is me talking about how I take care of me. I'm not saying you guys should do this yourself. My thing is always do your research, and if you have a physician that you love and adore, and who actually listens to you, then go talk to your physician. There's nothing wrong. The medical field has its place, but we have to understand how to navigate them and speak to them, because they're going to speak over you and speak on top of you until you finally learn how to talk to them. And also learn how to let doctors go. My thing when I was dealing with, the good cut the with the four gentlemen when I was in the hospital with the nerve pain initially, I reminded them, you're not paying. I'm actually paying you. I go, my insurance, which I pay for, pays for you. I go, so you are not going to tell me. You're going to hear me and listen to me. I'm going to ask for some other people. Period. And now, in their world, that makes me a bitchy woman because I had the audacity to speak up. Okay, I'm good with it. Trust me. If you need to call me this, I'm good with it. It takes nothing from my truth of who I am. I'm a great person. But there's no way you're going to bully me, especially reference to my health. So if you hear me doing different things, I'm acting crazy again. I think I'm going to send this joker back. I'm not really happy with it. But anyway, hopefully everything's fine, sound-wise. So I'm going to be bringing the health piece in, because I also think in terms of weight loss. Because right now we're in the whole new year, new me. Woo, we're going to do a new year, new me. Remember, I was in the weight loss industry for 10. We love this time of year, just so you know, because we make a ton of money. In the weight loss industry, a ton of money is made this time of year, and spring's another time, and back to school, the other time. But I'm going to also be introducing this because there are some things I do desire for you to know, so you once again you're making wise decisions around your health and well-being. So that's all I wanted to share today, because I just ordered her book, Dr. Jen, whatever her name is, on the menopause thing. I'm going to be sharing some information with you guys, because once again, my goal is for you to be in a good place. My desire is for you to be happy, physically, emotionally, mentally, spiritually, so that you're in the space to make wise decisions about your life. So anyway, go ahead and click on the button. Get the books, get the workbooks. That's a great place to start, because it's also going to give you an idea of what your mental state is and your emotional state is, so you can begin to think about how and why you're making the decisions that you're making. And even better, enroll in a class. Once again, it's only $99. And then also, you enroll in the class, it'll put you in a position that you can be part of the twice a month phone calls that I do, group calls I do with the goddaughters. So until we speak again, have an awesome day.